I focus my research on understanding the etiology of human papillomavirus, which is the virus that causes cervical cancer in women. It also causes some cancers at other anatomic sites. What's really interesting is over the last 2 decades, we've also come to understand that HPV causes cancers in the head and neck as well. So I aim to understand not only how these cancers arise, why HPV causes cancer at these sites, but more importantly, how we can prevent them. I feel honored to be a part of the Costa Rica vaccine trial. It's really been key in moving the field forward. A great example of that is the finding that you don't need all 3 doses to achieve a high vaccine efficacy.
So what was your reaction when you saw the efficacy?
I jumped up and down. I actually did. I was so excited and surprised. We were hopeful and optimistic that the protection against with 2 doses would be there, but we never thought that we'd observe that even a single dose protected you just as well. Within this one study, we now understand that this HPV vaccine protects really at any anatomic site where HPV causes cancer in a woman. Doing HPV research at the National Cancer Institute is really an amazing opportunity because we have some of the world's experts on HPV here. We're tackling really big problems that are very difficult. You know, the questions that we look at are not straightforward. And I think really this team approach is what leads to our very high quality of science that we put out. For me, it's really important to focus on study topics that have a very quick translational potential. I want to know that I'm doing research, that my finding has the potential to make a difference. Mentoring is absolutely critical here in DCEG, and I feel very fortunate because not only do I have a single mentor who I've worked with now for several years, but I actually have a committee that also takes the time to mentor me. Now, it must be said that as I become more senior and I get further away from my PhD and my postdoc, the actual amount of support is less. And, you know, and as part of that transition now, I've taken on fellows of my own and I've started to mentor them. I love this job. I think it's an amazing opportunity. And I love coming to work every day because I think that when I come to work, I have the potential to change people's lives from the work that gets done right here in this building.